Yo, what's up, YouTube? Welcome back to J3 Entertainment. You guys know what time it is.
Look, it's time to react, y'all.
Yes, it is, brother. And what are we reacting to today?
So we got a behind-the-scenes footage of Extraction 2, the Netflix sequel, original movie.
Now, I don't know if I should be watching this, bro.
No, you should.
I never watched Extraction 1.
I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to give you a breakdown. Sorry, I'm going to catch you up.
All right, okay.
So this movie came out during the pandemic in 2020, and Chris Hemsworth's character is Tyler Rake. He's a black market mercenary that's going on this extraction mission to rescue the kidnapped son of an international crime lord.
Okay.
By himself.
Okay.
And he's going in, you know, no backup, extreme measures, outgunned, outnumbered, things like that, just on a one-man mission. And it's all like military, tactical, and things like that. So he's kind of like doing like modern-day James Bond stuff, but he's like an Afghan soldier.
Okay.
Yeah.
So and, it's okay for me to watch the first look?
Yeah, because they're letting you know the style of action, the new styles of action, the storytelling that they're going to bring. All the practical stuff, all the stunt work. The guy that directed this is Sam Hargrave.
Okay.
He's a stuntman coordinator. He's the guy that made Chris Evans look tight in the Captain America, the Civil War, he's and Winter Soldier.
He's the one that made him look tight.
Yeah, he's that dude. And Extraction was his directorial film debut, and this is a sequel. So he's back.
Okay.
And his name came up for projects like Blade and stuff. This dude can direct.
Well, let's go ask him. Can you direct?
Yeah, you're about to see. This
all right,
is,
all
yeah,
right,
you're about
right,
to see, bro.
All right, I'm about to look.
Yeah.
There's a moment when you say to yourself, it can't be done. But instead of backing down,
that was nice.
You push yourself forward into the unknown.
Day one of shooting, Extraction 2. We're back.
The title of two behind your name, you have to bring at least twice the action.
Okay.
Sam.
Woo!
Where the landscape is ever evolving. Where everything that got
I kinda got
doesn't
goosebumps,
mean a
bro.
Thing, unless you can do it bigger and better than ever before.
For Extraction 1, we had a major action sequence that felt like one continuous mm-hmm. shot. We call that a one-er. For Extraction 2, we're going to push things further with a sequence more intricate and more extreme than before.
Yo, did they move the camera through the
yeah. helicopter? That's that raid stuff.
The rooftop of moving trains.
Wow.
That's pretty damn exciting.
I'm very proud of what we've done.
The end result is going to blow people's minds.
Against all odds, you find a way to make the impossible.
3, 2, 1, fire!
Just another target.
This looked tight.
Yeah, man.
You sold me.
Yeah.
You know who else saw this and is probably like, God damn it.
Yeah.
You know, saw it? You know who said that?
Oh.
TC. Okay, okay.
Right.
You think you're... Okay,
yeah.
My movie comes out next year.
Yep.
Chris Hemsworth.
That's what it's about. Competition is a great
Cruise.
Thing. Yeah, man. I love it that Netflix has given us that kind of big scope of something that feels like it could be in theaters. But this had a budget behind it, bro. And everything was real, practical. And I like action, man. Chris Hemsworth, man, when he's doing stuff like this, you see his charisma. And, like you feel like he's kind of like hindered back in the Marvel movies. Like you get to really see him act and like carry a movie, shows emotion and all that. And what was cool is he was on screen with David Harbour, who was in the first one. So Extractions, they're setting up his own universe. So there's other soldiers, there's other members.
You talking about Hopper?
Hopper, yeah. Hopper's in part one.
Well, isn't that?
Yeah. So.
Just prime.
The Russos, who are also co-writers and producers on this, they said that Extraction is building as a universe, and part two is about to expand it.
Gray Man?
Yeah. So Extraction was just the tip of the iceberg.
So
we only saw one soldier. Well, two technically.
So you're telling me this can lead into the Gray Man?
I don't know if they'll do that, but Extraction is going to be its own universe, cinematic universe. Because Gray Man already has books. That's separate.
Okay.
But
that's,
I mean,
okay, I got
the fan of me, like, it's like, yeah, that sounds tight, but like, it's his own thing. So Extraction is going to build his own universe.
Okay.
And Tyler Rake is like the new John McClane. He's that guy.
That's
you call
dope.
Him when you want to get some stuff done.
That's pretty tight, man.
He's
Netflix got their own little universe going on. That's kind
of
dope.
And we're in that renaissance and stage of stunt men and women directing action movies, and I love it because they're showing us it can be done. When you have people that understand stunts and understands that stunts are storytelling and acting as well.
Yeah.
We see it.
I don't know why they don't have a category in the Oscars for the best ass whooping in this film.
We're still asking for that.
You can't. That's great acting.
Yeah.
To portray someone getting their ass beat.
We don't make the rules. It's just, it is what it is.
Like, that, it'd be like, that's believable.
And that's 90% of your movie. Because the fight choreography, stunts, all that.
Just to show you some epicness, what's love got to do with it? When Tina finally turned on Ike, bro, and she grabbed him. Yeah, he's like, ah! Yeah. He took his cowboy boot off. Man, that's some great acting.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
And they came walking out in the hotel, all busted, jaws.
Beat up and stuff. Sold. You sold me.
That's great acting.
Yeah, man.
I can't make this up. How Eco runs and kicks somebody on the side of their head.
Yep.
Mad Dog.
Yep.
These.
This is what I do. Shooting somebody's like ordering takeout. That's some gangster stuff.
Bruh. Okay. Yeah, but I'm liking this. This has a lot of like how old boy did Ghost Rider 2, the brothers.
Yeah, the crank guys.
Yep,
yeah.
Yep. This had the,
Mark and Taylor, yeah.
See, it's crazy how you watch those movies back then and see how it elevates itself.
Yeah. People talked a lot of crap about it, but Ghost Rider is a Spirit of Vengeance had good action.
It had great action.
Very good action.
Trash, but had great action. Yeah.
So you overlooked it. Like, all right.
Yeah. That's kind of, when I saw, I remember seeing it, I was like, yo, this is good action.
I've never seen camera shots like that. That was like Daredevil movie making.
And they're
on the back of bikes, Kawasaki ninja bikes with cameras, like jumping from truck to truck. Like, what?
And they changed and they elevated because that's what I'm seeing now.
Yeah. Like, we got drones now. Like, following people on
Michael
the chase
Bay ambulance, bro.
Yeah.
He was like, I'm about to take this on.
We can take chase scenes to this level now?
And what was Will Smith's movie? Oh, can I say that word? Is his name now? Is it okay? What was Will Smith's movie when it was his son? It was him and he was younger. It was like a clone. What, Ang Lee did it?
Gemini Man.
Did Ang Lee do that?
Yes.
Man, the first 45 minutes of that movie was beautiful.
Yeah.
And then the
very
budget
kicked
in. Very
good post-conversion 3D. Very good 3D.
Then the budget kicked in.
Yeah.
And then he looked like Gemini cousin. He was all blurry at the end.
That was some of the best 3D I've seen since Avatar. Like, that was crazy.
For 45
level.
Minutes.
Yeah.
It was clean. Then the Resident Evil kicked
how he
in.
Did that. Yeah.
I said, that ain't Will Smith. That's a dummy. Is that Woody from Toy Story? Oh, no. That's Stretch Armstrong.
It's him.
Yeah, that's him right there.
Yep.
That's Plastic Man.
Yep.
But no, you saw me, man.
Next level.
You and C. Smith been talking about this and Sable talking about this distraction. And I don't know, man.
Distraction's tight, bro. So, he's going to watch the first one, y'all. He's going to watch it.
I'll watch it. Yeah. I'll definitely watch it. I don't know what you guys think in the comments down below, man, because this looks dope, man.
You saw them camera shots? I've seen them shots.
Ronan be putting me up on some stuff, man. You know, I appreciate you, brother. I really do.
No problem.
I really do. But it's not about us.
It's about y'all.
Post your comments down below. Let us know what you guys think. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and press the subscribe button. Thumbs up this video. Don't forget to share Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Also, follow us on Instagram and Twitter.
Yep.
I'm J3.
On the show, Ninja Assassin.
100,000 subscribers, guys.
We're on our way.